you for joining us for this week's KHSD News. I'm Erin Briscoe Clark. Ag students prepare all year for the Kern County Fair, but this year preparations looked different as in-person activities were canceled and the fair went virtual. Last year at this time, North High junior Alexa Branson was in the fairgrounds ring showing her animal in front of judges. This year, she submitted this video as part of the competition.
It is very different because like walking into the ring, you get all these nerves and everything instead of sending a video, and you can always redo it until you get the perfect one instead of being there in the actual judge's presence where everything matters.
Last month, fair officials announced changes to the fair due to the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic.
You know, we're really lucky that the Kern County Fair has gone out of their way to figure out a way for students to still get to participate in this opportunity.
A team of judges from across the country viewed the videos, and on Thursday, the fair held its virtual crowning of champions with multiple KHSD students walking away as livestock champions. And from October 1st to the 3rd, the fair is holding its annual auction virtually.
One thing that's really stood out is that high school students have a lot of resiliency. So it's been impressive to see students tackle something this big, a pandemic that nobody saw coming, and still just figure out a way to make it work.
We have a link to the list of livestock champions on our website, kernhigh.org. Congratulations to all of the students for demonstrating hard work, dedication, and leadership. We'd like to give a shout out to West High School senior Jesus Naranjo for representing West High School and the district during the virtual California Coalition of Early and Middle Colleges Conference. Jesus served on the student panel and discussed his experience with dual enrollment. A group of Kern Valley High students took it upon themselves to keep the school connected, even if they can't be together on campus. They started this student-run newspaper, KVHS Highlights. The first digital edition included a student poll, articles about what's new on campus, a sports update, a staff highlight, and student art submissions. The paper comes out monthly, and students can find it in their Google Classroom, Canvas announcements, and on the Kern Valley High website. Hispanic Heritage Month continues to be celebrated by schools across the district. West High School is highlighting its 2017 and 2018 History Field Day teams as they created documentaries recognizing major events in Hispanic history in the modern era. The 2017 team produced the documentary Lost Headlines, Mendez versus Westminster, highlighting civil rights activist Sylvia Mendez, who at a young age played a role in the 1946 landmark desegregation case, Mendez versus Westminster.
But was the Hoover School for Mexicans in Westminster really equal?
It was right next to a dairy. And at that time, the dairies were allowed to have fences that had wire on them and they had electricity on them. And if you touched the wire, you would get shocked. And that was the fence between the school and the dairy that we were going to there in Westminster. It was all dirt, it was no grass, we didn't have a playground, and it was just two wooden buildings, and that was a Mexican school.
The documentary placed third out of 46 documentaries at the State History Day competition. You can view the documentary on West High School's website. All month long, we have been celebrating and recognizing the rich history and contributions made by Hispanic and Latinx individuals. Be sure to check out our website, kernhigh.org, where we will be sharing stories, videos, and celebrations from across the district. And finally, we'd like to say thank you to our hardworking custodial staff across the district on this National Custodial Worker Day. Each day, our teams work hard to ensure that our school sites, offices, and other facilities are spotless and sanitary. Especially right now, teams are working diligently to make sure that we all stay safe. So thank you for all of your hard work and all that you do today and every day. And that's going to do it for this week's KHSD News. Thanks for watching. Stay connected to all things happening across the district by following us on Twitter at KHSD_official. See you next week.